Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Bharat Test Guru. Today we are going to talk about the topic related to the checks which is useful in our competitive exams like IBPS and SSE. Check is a negotiable instrument type. First we will see what is check. An order to a bank to pay a stated sum from the drawer's account written on a specially printed form. A check is a document that orders a bank to pay a specific amount of money from a person's account, from the drawer's account to the person in whose name the check has been issued. A person orders the bank to pay a particular amount of money to the person in whose name the check has been issued. The drawer writes various details like including the monetary amount, date and payee on the check and signs it, ordering their bank known as drawee to pay that person or company the amount of money stated. In the checks, we have mainly three terms. Those are drawer, payee and drawee. Drawer is the person the check issued by. The one who is issuing the check, that particular person is called drawer. Drawee is generally banks, the issuer of checks, and payee is the one who receives the money from the banks or the payee may be a person or company. Here we have different types of checks. Those are order check, crosser check, bearer check and open check. Let's see one by one. Crosser check. By using the crosser check, we can't encash directly at the cash counter of a bank, but it can credit it to the payee's account. The payee cannot get the cash directly from the counter of a bank, but it is credited to the payee's account. A common instruction is to specify that it must be deposited directly into the account with the bank and not immediately cashed by a bank over the counter. Here, in the cash is not getting directly from the cash counter of a bank, but it is credited to the account of payees. A check can be crossed by drawing two transverse parallel lines across the check with or without writing account payee or not negotiable. These parallel lines is drawn upper left hand corner of the check. Upper left hand corner of the check, two parallel lines will be drawn. Then it is called crosser check. Bearer check, a check which is payable to any person who presents it for payment at the bank counter is called bearer check. In this bearer check, the word bearer appears on the face of the check. This check is payable to any person present at the counter of a bank. If the bearer check will be lost, the finder of a check can collect the payment from the bank. If once issued the bearer check, there is no chance of cancellations. In the bearer check, we can't cancel the. Once issued the bearer check, there is no chance of cancellations. Order check. An order check is the one which is payable to a particular person. This is the check is payable to a person specified therein as a payee. For the particular person as a payee or to anyone else whom it is transferred, whom it is endorsed, we can cancel the order checks. Whereas in the bearer check, there is no chance of cancellations and anybody can collect the money from the cash counter of a bank. But whereas in the order check, we can cancel the checks and for particular payees only we are giving the amount. Next, open check. A check is called open when it is possible to get cash over the counter at the bank. The holder of open check can do the following: receive its payment over the counter at the bank, deposit the check in his own account or pass it to someone else by signing on the back of a check. Open check may be a bearer check or order check. Here it can obtain at the counter of a bank. By using the open check, we are receiving the payment at the cash counter, or we can deposit into our own accounts, or we can transfer the money, we can pass it to anybody by signing the back of a check. Next, categorization of checks. Here we have different categories of checks. Those are antedated checks, stale check, mutilated check, post-date check. Antedated checks. Check in which the drawer mentions the date earlier to the date of presenting it for payment. A check is having the earlier date on which it is presented to the bank. Then that is called antedated checks. These checks are valid up to 3 months from the date of issue. Generally, checks are having the validity period of 3 months from the date of issue. Stale check. A check presented after certain period, typically 6 months, of its payment date. A bank may refuse it to honor it unless the drawer issues the new payment date or by issuing the new checks. In the stale check, if it is presented to the counter after certain period, like after 6 months, then it is called stale check. Stale check is not honored by the banks. It is not an invalid check, but it may be a valid when drawer issues a new payment date or new check. Mutilated check. In case a check is torn into two or more pieces and presented for payment, such checks is called mutilated check. If a check is cut into two or more pieces and presented for payments at the cash counter of a bank, then it is called mutilated check. The bank will not make payments against this mutilated checks without getting the confirmation of drawer. Post-date check. Check on which drawer mentions the date which is subsequent to the date on which it is presented is called post-date check. A check present at the counter having the subsequent year, having the subsequent date, then it is called post-dated check. It is honored only on the issue date. Next, here we have one more concept related to the checks, check truncation. Check truncation is the conversion of physical check into a substitute electronic form for transmission to the paying bank. Check truncation reduces or eliminates the physical movement of checks and reduces the time and cost of processing the check clearance system. There are three parties in the check: drawer or maker, check is issued by the one, the bank on whom the check is drawn, payee, the payee is the person whose name is mentioned on the check to whom or whose order the money is directed to be paid. Here, check truncation. For fast clearing of the checks, for doing fastness, we are using the check truncation system. In this check truncation, checks are drawn in the electronic form for the transmission. And in the conversion of the physical form into the electronic form, then we are using the check truncation. By using the check truncation, its processing speed will be increases. The processing speed of the checks will be increases, whereas the time is reduced. For moving the checks, it is time reduction will be there and processing speed will be increases. Here we have three parties in the checks: drawer or maker, check is issued by the one who is issuing, the person who is getting, who is withdrawn money from it, from their accounts, that person is called drawer. The bank on whom the check is drawn, generally issuer of checks is called bank. Payee, who is getting the money, the person whose name is mentioned on the check, that person is called payee. Next, here we have questions related to the checks. We'll see who is primarily liable on a check. The primary liable on a check is drawer. It is A. Option A. The drawer of a check is always A. Who is drawer of a Who is drawer of a check? The drawer of a check always customer. Hence the option is C. The effect of crossed check is, in the crossed check, the payee cannot obtain the cash directly. It is credited to the account of a payee's account. Here option is A. The payee can obtain the payment through bank account. Which of the following is a banker's check? Generally demand drafts are called banker's check. Hence the option is A. Check remains valid for payments from the date of issue. check remains valid from the date of issue. It is 3 months. The validity period for the check is 3 months. Thanks for watching. Thanks to Prasad sir. Please do like and subscribe us for more topics like this.